What is going on, guys? It's Wednesday, and that means that
paintball crunch time.
The best paintball pod harnesses for $50. The state of Bob Long / Field One. And is there going to be an E-Tech 6 at World Cup? Storm 1030 asks, what is a good pod harness to get if I'm looking to spend $50 to $60? So I think there's like two companies that make really good quality, good value packs that are a little actually under that price. Valken and Empire. So Valken make a couple, right? They make the Fate Harness that I like a lot. It's priced very well. So the Fate Harness is a 4+3 pack, so you're able to hold 7 pods, and it's only $27.95. The Fate Harness, though, is very basic, so don't expect like any crazy features or superior build quality. It's under 30 bucks, so don't expect too much. It's not made the greatest, it's pretty basic, but it's $27.95, like it's just cheap. And I prefer to say inexpensive, and maybe cheap too. Valken also make the Crusade Harness. The Crusade only comes in black and can only be had in a 3+6. So you're able to put 9 pods in it, which is still quite a bit. The Crusade Harness is $44.95. The Crusade Harness is definitely constructed quite a bit better than that Fate Harness though. It's just better. Like the materials are better, it just feels better. The pod holders are definitely more rigid, so they're gonna like hold up over time. One of the things that I really like about the Crusade Harness is that little pouch. I'm a fan of this pouch. It allows you to like store keys, maybe an Allen wrench, some money, an ID, whatever it is. It's just nice so I don't lose stuff. The Crusade Harness also has that padding on the pack, right? Where it sits in the small of your back, just makes the thing comfortable. My favorite though, the Empire React Harnesses. The React Harness comes in 6 different configurations. Solid black, which is black. And then Empire's TerraPat camouflage pattern. And then within those two colors, there's also 3 size configurations, a 3+6, a 4+7, and a 5+8. And can be had for $40, $43, $45. And I just like them a lot. This right here, that's their TerraPat color, a 4+7 TerraPat. That's that $43 one, that middle-sized and middle-priced one. They're just made really well. I just like them. They're good, good quality packs, extremely good value. They also have like that Valken pack, the little pocket on the belt. I like the implementation of the Empire one a little bit more. Feels a little bit more durable, a little bit more solid. You can shove about the same amount of stuff in there. And when I used my Empire pack, like I used that thing every single time I played, always put an Allen wrench in there so I wouldn't lose it. The React packs, also like the Crusade Harness, have a little bit of padding on your back right there. It's gonna be definitely thicker than the Crusade though, so it's gonna probably be a little bit more comfortable. Yeah, I like the React packs, but you asked like $50 to $60, and those are all under 50. I don't know, I don't think there's a pack that's like 50 to 60 that's much better than those 3. Like those are for sure my favorite 3. There is also the Dye Jet pack. I just literally just thought about it. I totally left that out. Those are also good, but I think I would still probably choose the React Harness. I think that's the best thing under like 80 bucks, really. NL Mark 1983, could you give an overview of the current Bob Long / Field One markers? Big fan of the show, thank you. Greetings from the Netherlands. Oh, the Netherlands is so cool. Never been there, so I really don't know. But it's really far that way. That's east. Someday I hope to visit your fair country very soon. Let's start with saying that, like, my memory is awful, so I could be off on this. But about a year ago, Bob Long sold Bob Long to some of the Dynasty guys. I think Alex Frangie's involved, Yo Shirao, and I think Ryan Greenspan, maybe, and, like, Eric Crandall, like, manager of Dynasty. Those guys, they're still making, though, a lot of the Bob Long guns. Like, you can get Onslaughts, MVPs, G6Rs they're still making. So they're still making some of those guns that Bob's been making for the past, like, 4 years. But they do have some new stuff coming out. They've definitely shown, like, pictures and images of a new MVP2, a Mark Victory Pump 2, and a Force, their new, like, flagship high-end spool valve gun. Both of those hopefully we see very soon. I mean, they showed them off in February, and we're hoping, I definitely am hoping, that we see them at World Cup. Like, I would really like to see the Force. I want it to be cool. I want it to be a good paintball gun. I think we need more competition in this high-end gun market rather than just Eclipse and Die taking over. So I'm hoping that the Force is a cool gun. They've also kind of hinted at a G7R. They haven't shown pictures of like any official dates or prices or anything like that, but they're like, yeah, we're working on it. That's all they've said though. So maybe late next year, early next year, maybe we'll see pictures or images of a G7R. That's the state of Bob Long, or I always say that, Field One, you can buy old guns, and then we have new ones coming. William Lockhart asked, E-Tech 6 at World Cup? I don't think so. That's kind of a common thing though. Everyone's always wanted to know like, when the Axe 3 is coming out, and like, when's the E-Tech 6 and G-Tech 2? Not for a while, right? I think these companies try to like ride out these mid-rangey guns for like 4 or 5 years. Because say they have to spend like X amount of dollars on a gun to get made, which is the same price, right? So they're spending the same amount of money on like the G-Tech versus the like CS1 on engineering and like designing it and stuff. So they're making way more money on the CS1 when they sell it. So they're able to like, you know, come out with guns every 2 years. But on these mid-rangey, lower-end guns, they're just not making as much money when they sell it. So they kind of have to get that money back over the long term versus like 2 years. So they're not coming out with guns all the time. So the E-Tech 6 has been out like, I don't know, two-ish, three-ish years. So maybe next year we'll see a gun, but I don't know. I think we'd see in G-Tech 2 before we would in E-Tech 6. I was like, the Spoolvov guns have just gotten way more popular. So I could see them coming out with a new version of the G-Tech before they do the E-Tech. Because the E-Tech, let's face it, is not selling nearly as well as like the ETH 2 or G-Tech are. So maybe next year, but definitely not this year. I shouldn't say definitely not, I don't really know, but I would be very, very surprised if we'd see an E-Tech 6 at World Cup. Some things I'm confident we'll see though, I think pretty confident we'll see a new CS2. I actually did like a wish list video thing up here. Check that out if you want to see my wish list for the new high-end Spoolvov Eclipse gun. And definitely the G-Mech, that mechanical G-Tech. Those are two guns that I'm pretty confident we'll see at World Cup. I could look like an idiot, I don't know, but I assume we'll see those things. That's Paintball Question Time, guys. To have your question answered on Paintball Question Time, submit a comment below or use hashtag PBQT and I will find the thing. To check out more Paintball Question Times, hit that big rectangular box. It'll take you to a bunch of videos on paintball questions. To subscribe, hit that circle button or hit that shirt and buy something at the Paintball Room My Life store.